Now, guys, these are the eggs. We got Vital Farms, True Blues, pasture-raised heirloom eggs. I already got them cracked. Hope you guys can see the color of those yolks. If you can, let me come up to the camera for you guys.
None of y'all stopping me, no need to ask. Chopping trees, planting seeds, plotting schemes, crossing eyes, stopping T's. Lines are blurred, I cannot see. Before I die, I'm top three. Before I die, I'm top three.
You telling me how many reps I gotta do? Okay. Okay. What is going on, YouTube? Back in the kitchen, cooking with the Prez. Today I'm gonna be bringing you the healthiest mass building shake you're ever gonna come across. Now, as you guys know, I talked about this the last couple times in the most recent videos. I've been increasing my calories lately, going back into a surplus. Currently, my calories been falling around 32 to 3300 per day. On an off day or a day I don't train, I may lower the calories just down to maintenance, which is 3000, but I'm no longer staying in the deficit at all, right? You guys wanna put on muscle, you guys wanna build muscle, don't be scared to put on a little bit of body fat and make sure, you know, you take that recovery. Because remember, if you're a hard gainer like me, remember last winter was the first time I passed 170 pounds in my life, and I had 175 max weight on competition day. And now all summer long, I've stayed the leanest at the heaviest weight ever. I hovered around 166, 167 all summer. Right now I'm laying around 170 pounds. So if you're a hard gainer, like I was saying, the more you do, the more you train, the more you're gonna burn, the more you're gonna have to fuel your body. Last winter, I hit a high calorie intake of around 36, maybe 3,700 calories on a couple days. This winter, I'm looking to push it a little higher. I'm gonna look to push the 4,000 calories. I'm trying to pass 175. So I have a better starting point. I'm at a heavier starting point now. And I'm not trying to do it too quickly either. Like I said, my lowest on the deficit, I hit almost 2,600 calories. But being that low, I was getting injured a lot, and I was just undernourished and everything, and it wasn't optimal for my body. So I've been slowly reverse dieting back into a bulk now. And like I said, falling around 3,100, 3,200 calories a day. So this is my mass building shake. Have all the ingredients laid out. We're gonna start with the base, which is gonna be, I have this 100% grass-fed, unsweetened kefir. Ideally, I would be getting this raw, but I only get raw milk deliveries once a week, and it's midweek right now, and I didn't get it last weekend. So we're going to use the best we can get. Remember, kefir is gonna be fermented dairy. There's gonna be no lactose in it. It has a ton of probiotics, very good for the gut. So if you can't handle dairy, if you can't handle whole milk, you may be able to handle whole cow milk, unsweetened, organic grass-fed kefir. We're gonna start the base with 200 grams of the kefir, a little heavier now. So the calories that I actually track when I tell you at the end are gonna be a little higher. So 200 grams of kefir, there's not much protein on it. So 170 gram serving is 7 grams of fat, 8 grams of carbs, and only 5 grams of protein, right? So this isn't gonna be our main protein source, but again, very good for the gut, very good for digestion. So I added 30 extra grams, so maybe I'm at 140 calories instead of 120 from here. Boom, next. Banana. Now I wanna hit at least 120 grams of banana. If I have to, I will get another banana. We can get another one. Back. All right, so we're gonna go, since we got another one open, we're gonna go 150, 150 grams of banana. Save the rest for the next shake. Now guys, these are the eggs. We got Vital Farms, True Blues, pasture-raised heirloom eggs. I already got them cracked. Hope you guys can see the color of those yolks. If you can, let me come up to the camera for you guys. Look at that. You want dark orange, nice yolks, guys. No pale yolks in my shakes, especially when we're drinking them raw. So raw, three eggs, boom, boom, boom. And to be honest, I can do that raw easy. Eggs really don't taste bad. Now, what we're going to add. Actually, we're going to add this last. We're going to add next our raw, unfiltered, 100% organic honey. The benefits of raw honey, it's going to have all, remember, if you get pasteurized honey, meaning it was heated, you're going to lose the pollen, the enzymes, the propolis, and all the minerals that come with raw, unfiltered honey. So if you got a bee allergy, if you guys got allergies, listen, I think, I don't know if there's any science back this, the more honey you eat, allergies are gonna get better, right? You might get stung by a few more bees. Might be a, you know, you might be a little sweeter. But we're gonna go one serving of honey, which is about 21 grams. Beautiful, boom. That's gonna be our sweetener. Amazing. Then we're gonna add, do not knock it until you try it. Orange and banana and vanilla. Oh man, tastes like a vanilla creamsicle. No vanilla in here, but we're gonna put just for a little bit of liquid, just 2 ounces of, again, raw, fresh, squeezed orange juice, unpasteurized. Okay, I would prefer almond butter here, but I ran out of it. So we got organic peanut butter. If you got organic peanut butter, when the only ingredient is organic Valencia peanuts or organic peanuts and salt, make sure there's no palm oils, no soy oils, no safflower oils, no sugars in your nut butters. And the reason why I prefer almond butter over peanut butter is just peanuts in general tend to be a little more of a toxic food. You know, they could grow mold on it. Almonds also seem to be a little higher in a better omega profile and easier to digest, so. But, you know, you can never go wrong with some good old peanut butter. We're gonna put 1 serving of peanut butter, 32 grams, guys. That's why we got the scale going. I weigh, I track, I know exactly how many calories are going into this shake. I know exactly how many calories I'm eating. And if you guys are serious about your goals, whether it's gaining weight, losing weight, you need to get a food scale. You need to be tracking your food. All right. Now the magic sauce, guys. We got raw liver. We're gonna put about 1.5 ounces of raw liver in here. You will not taste it one bit. Boom. Get another little piece in there. All right, guys, and that is a wrap for all the ingredients. So we got 200 grams of kefir, 150 grams of banana, 32 grams of peanut butter, 2 ounces of orange juice, 21 grams of raw unpasteurized honey, 3 raw organic eggs, 1.5 ounces of raw grass-fed beef liver. I'm gonna blend all this up, show you guys the final product. And we're back, just blended it up, literally right here in my bullet. This is exactly what it looks like. All you literally taste is a slight sourness from the kefir, because remember, kefir is fermented, so it's gonna have a slight tang to it, especially if you're getting the unflavored one, and the egg yolks, and the honey, and the orange. That's all you taste. The reason why I'm calling this the healthiest mass building shake you're ever gonna take is because it literally is. It is packed full of all 100% whole food ingredients, all living, raw, organic ingredients. Nothing is dead, nothing, even though it's, you know, we're eating meat and we're eating protein, it's not, you know, okay, the liver is not from a living animal, but it's never been cooked. It's all unpasteurized, raw. The liver is gonna be extremely high in vitamin A, beta carotene, eggs as well, high in omega-3s, healthy fatty acids, healthy protein. You're gonna get good complex carbs from the banana. Healthy gut-friendly probiotics and gut bacteria from the kefir. And all, again, no supplements, no powders, no pills. You're not gonna find any pill or any powder that's gonna give you this much nutrition in one shot. Total calories on here, like I said, are probably gonna be falling around 750 to 800. Depending on how many or how much liquid you guys put in. And I tracked it without putting 100, like I said, I tracked with 170 grams of kefir and 120 grams of banana. I ended up using 150 grams of banana and 200 grams of kefir. So I probably added, like I said, maybe 50 calories. So between 750 to 800 calories right here. High in protein, healthy fats, carbohydrates. This is gonna revitalize. This is gonna bring you all that nourishment that your body needs. Again, it doesn't have to be done on a cut. I mean, it doesn't have to be done on a bulk. It could be done on a cut. The only difference is you got to know how many calories you have to eat to be in a deficit, and you got to know how many calories you have to eat to being a surplus, which is exactly what I'm doing now. So here's a little quick nutrition video. Let me know in the comment section what other nutrition videos you guys want to see next. And a lot more content to come, guys. Like I said, we have a lot in the works. The new house, the new gym is all set up. Well, the house ain't ready yet, but you guys are going to be updated when it is. The new gym is done. We've been training in there. The new program, the new routine that I'm doing, I put it on the last video. You guys literally follow the same 3-day full body split. Let's build muscle. Let's get these gains together. Let's stay healthy. Stay out of the doctor's office. Take care of your bodies, guys. It's your car. This is the fuel that you got to put in, right? So make sure you treat it as such. Nourish it. Let's get it, guys. I'll see you in the next one.
Sad story, I ain't here for a symphony, no sympathy. When I was on the bench, you wouldn't sit with me. Now I'm on the court and I'm balling, my time's coming.